Have you ever thought of the legacy that Kaiba's anime deck has left behind? After covering the insane amount of decks that have spawned from Yugi's one anime deck, basically, this is what we would call a Yugi deck back in 2002. It's just got all of his iconic monsters inside. Whereas now, that one deck has evolved into 18 different decks. That is literally one new deck for each of Yugi's iconic monsters. So, with that in mind, Seto Kaiba, the second most popular character in the entire Yu-Gi-Oh! Franchise. His original anime deck is stuffed with so many iconic monsters and cards that, well, there must be tons of new decks that have spun off from his one deck in the modern day, just like Yugi, right? No, it is in fact spun off into four decks. At most, I can make a wiggle room for 5-6 decks at most, but four seems to be the most solid number, with six being probably if we give it a bit of wriggle room. To make sure I've got this right, let's go through each of his iconic monsters, see what has or hasn't got their own decks now, and at the end, we can come up with some hypotheticals of what we could spin off some of the cards into in terms of decks. Let's take a look first at Kaiba's most iconic monsters. Kaiba's three Blue Eyes White Dragons and their fused form, Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon. Today, we have a Blue Eyes White Dragon deck. Now, while there's always been support for the Blue Eyes White Dragon with cards like Lord of D or Paladin of White Dragon, nowadays, it has been supported to hell and back. In fact, many of us, when we think of Kaiba's deck, do think of it as a Blue Eyes deck. However, in the anime, it's always been more of a beatdown deck, with Kaiba's favorite cards being the Blue Eyes White Dragons. They're always the tip of the spear kind of thing. And though later Kaiba decks do tend to shift more as a dragon beatdown deck with Blue Eyes White Dragon and its ultimate form, still, they were never really Blue Eyes decks. That is until now. We have full-fledged Blue Eyes archetype cards, support cards, everything. We have brand new versions of the Blue Eyes White Dragon like Alternative, Deep Eyes Abyss, Spirit of, and Solid. We have new support monsters like the White Stones and the Sages. We also have some modern versions of some classic Kaiba cards rolled into the Blue Eyes package. Remember Lord of D? Remember Kaiser Seahorse? Well, now we have Neo Kaiser Seahorse and Dictator of D. Pretty cool. Not only that, but we have other Blue Eyes fusions like Twin Burst, Neo Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon, Dragon Master Magia. However, this card is more of a Yugi and Kaiba hybrid card, so it belongs to both, I guess. We have a new Ritual, Chaos Max, new Synchros, Spirit Dragon, Spirit Ultimate Dragon, Azure Dragon. And we now have, for the very first time, a Blue Eyes Link monster, known as Spirit with Eyes of Blue. Now, I will say, in defense of Kaiba, while I don't think his original deck has branched off into as many different decks as Yugi's has, his Blue Eyes White Dragon has had the exact same treatment the Dark Magician archetype has had. These two archetypes are the decks that just keep on giving because Konami likes to support them and there's a lot of people out there that like them being supported. Now, after Blue Eyes, we have X, Y, and Z, as well as its fusions. Today, we have the ABC and VWXYZ decks, which, when you merge them together, are known as the A to Z deck. We have A Assault Core, B Buster Drake, C Crush Wyvern, and their contact fuse form, ABC Dragon Buster. Something I completely forgot Kaiba never used, VW and VW Tiger Catapult. Well, that was Chaz Princeton card from Yu-Gi-Oh! GX. I really remember Kaiba using it, but he absolutely didn't. Following from that, we got Kaiba's X, Y, and Z fused with Chaz's VW to make VWXYZ Dragon Catapult Cannon. We also have a combination of all the fusions, which is A to Z Buster Cannon. And you'd think this would be enough new support along with all the spells and traps, but no. They have actually gone back and retrained the original X, Y, and Z. I imagine VW will come at some point, but for the time being, we now have X Cross Cannon, Y Dragon Year Head, Z Zillion Tank, and their new fused form, XYZ Hyper Dragon Cannon. And still, we're not done. Kaiba's iconic quick play spell, Enemy Controller, I would say probably his most iconic spell, this now is a fusion form called Union Controller, and it too supports the XYZ archetype. Honestly, it's come a long way from where it started. And the thing is, it's not just exclusive to Kyber's cards as well. If you're going to class the GX series as well, obviously there's a character called Chaz Princeton that played the VWXYZ cards as well. And because of that, he has his own Armed Dragon Catapult Cannon Monster, which is a merger of his Armed Dragon series and the XYZ series. There'll probably be an Ojama version of it soon, but there's definitely Ojama cards that support this as well. After this, do you remember those two times Kyber used Thunder Dragon and Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon? Well, today they have their own full-fledged Thunder Dragon deck. Which, awesomely, the original Thunder Dragon, it is still usable in the Thunder Dragon archetype, since they revolve all around hand abilities of Thunder monsters, like that's part of the effect. It's just a great way to get monsters to your hand. However, sadly, Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon, that doesn't see any more play now, but that's fine because it's been completely outpaced by its new upgraded forms, Thunder Dragon Colossus and Thunder Dragon Titer, which can be made super easily via their own effects or with the spell Thunder Dragon Fusion. It's worth noting as well, this deck actually has a Link monster Thunder Dragon, which I didn't know existed because I've never seen somebody play Thunder Dragon and summon this card. So it's either not very good or just too hard to make or something like that, but still it was cool to know there is one. And there's also a myriad of different Thunder Dragon monsters in the archetype. Yet again though, it just goes to show a card that Kyber barely used, but it got spun up into its own deck. Now, of course, Kyber went for a period as an Egyptian god user. His Egyptian god was Obelisk the Tormentor. And so, of course, he built his deck around it for Battle City. And so today we have an Obelisk Egyptian god deck. Not a ton of cards for this deck, especially when you compare it to the Winged Dragon of Ra support cards. Woofed. But still, it does have its own support cards like Soul Crossing, which, if you think about it, is an Egyptian god retrain of Soul Exchange, which was a classic Kyber card as well. And while we're talking about it, this card is also a reference to Kyber and Ishizu's duel. Other cards in this deck are the Breaking Ruin God, Fist of Fate, Soul Energy Max, and Magical Trick Mirror. Magical Trick Mirror, it took them long enough to make this card. Now, of course, with this deck, you're gonna have to mix something else into it to make it a full-fledged deck, but there's just enough cards in here where I can definitely class this as a Kyber modern day deck. So yeah, Obelisk deck. Now after these four decks, we start getting into, I think they are Kyber decks, but you could definitely make a case of saying, just about. So the first one we have is based on Kyber's Crush Card Virus. Today we kind of have a virus deck. The thing is though, virus cards don't have any like support monsters, any monsters at all or anything like that. It's just kind of the original Crush Card Virus, and it just has a bunch of different versions of itself. Kind of thing. The closest thing to support cards, I guess we could say for this archetype, was Kyber used a card called Giant Germ. That was part of like his virus entourage of cards, along with another card called Virus Cannon. And while yes, you can make a deck out of them, you are going to be mixing another deck into it. So it's kind of like whatever that deck is with the virus cards in it as well. So it's a hard one to say. I do like the fact that the virus cards, as they're released, follow the alphabet. Crush Card Virus, Deck Devastation Virus, Eradicator Epidemic Virus, Full Force Virus, and Grinning Grave Virus. That was off memory, that was pretty good. The theme with these cards is that they hit the opponent's decks in different ways, but they all require a dark monster to be tributed in order to be activated. Now, the monster that Kyber always used to activate these effects was Saggy the Dark Clown, which never really got a modern day retrain, so if they wanted to make a actual virus archetype and deck, they could make Saggy maybe the core of it. However, the only problem with that is nobody really wants a full-fledged virus deck. That would be one of the most toxic decks you would ever play against in your entire life, so we don't really want that. And it is worth noting that Saggy the Dark Clown does actually have a kind of retrain in Petten the Dark Clown, which made an appearance in the Pyramid of Light movie, and Petten the Dark Clown was used as the tribute to trigger the ability of Deck Destruction Virus, the virus card he used in the anime that doesn't exist. And while we're thinking about it, another card that could be repurposed into the virus archetype was a card that Kyber would typically use on his strong dark monsters to weaken them for Crush Card Virus to be live, and then he's Shrink. That could see a modern day retrain for the virus archetype, I guess. But yeah, no virus support. We don't want that really. Now, of course, Kyber wielded one of the legendary dragons. His card was the Fang of Critias. Today, it has its own legendary dragon deck. I'll be honest though, it's a little bit sparse. We kind of only have the cards Fang of Critias and Legend of Hearts. And then we have the fusions, which I do like the fact that each of the fusions requires a classic Kyber card to be made. Destruction Dragon, for example, needs Ring of Destruction. Tyrant Burst Dragon needs Tyrant Wing. Doom Virus Dragon needs Crush Card Virus. And I know it's not a Kyber card, but we also have Mirror Force Dragon. So that's just another one of those combined with Yugi deck kind of cards, similar to Magia, I guess, but still, they're pretty cool. Again, this is another one of those archetypes where unfortunately you have to mix a lot of other cards into the deck to make it into a full deck, but I feel like it just about makes the cut to be classed as a Kyber deck. Now this next one, it's a bit wacky, but do you remember that one time that Kyber summoned Vampire Lord? Keep in mind that it also did appear in the structure deck Kyber. So technically, this is a Kyber card, which means we should class the Vampire deck as one of his Monsters deck spin-offs. But is this really a Kyber deck? I don't know. Kyber has never really been associated with vampires, the occult, or anything like that. It just felt like a card that he used in a technically non-canon duel against his non-canon brother, I assume it is. You could make a case it probably shouldn't really be one of those things. And if you had to attach a character to the Vampire deck, you're gonna pick Camula from Yu-Gi-Oh! GX. It just makes much more sense. I don't know if you can really class this one. It appeared in his structure deck. He did play it once, so I'm not too sure. I'll let you guys be the judge of that one. And unfortunately, after this, we're out of decks that Kyber's original deck has spun off into. I mean, you could make a case for maybe Different Dimension Dragon. There is an archetype called the DD Different Dimension deck, but this card just feels so not a part of that. As much as I love this card, I love the design of this. I think it's really cool. It doesn't feel like it has its own spin-off. This is something I would like to see something get merged off into in the future though. We also have Chaos Emperor Dragon. Yes, Chaos Emperor Dragon did spin off into the Chaos archetype. There is a whole Chaos deck you can play now, but I can make the same case for Blacklister Soldier Envoy of the Beginning as well. And we do have the modern Chaos Emperor Dragon as well. So, I guess you can make a case for this one that the Chaos deck is a part of it, but it is really hard to say. Also, remember the card Cyberjar? Kyber never actually used this card, but it is a part of his deck. The dual robot uses it when it's playing as if it was Kyber, and Yugi uses it after he takes over Kyber's deck in the Noah duel as well. But a lot of other characters use Cyberjar. This feels like kind of like a staple card, like Monster Reborn or Pot of Greed or something. Just a couple characters seem to play. I don't even know if I can class the Jar series of cards or monsters as part of his like spin-off deck or something. And you couldn't really make a deck out of them anyway. After this, it just becomes a case of what cards did Kyber play that we would like to see made into a full-fledged deck, retrained into like a single deck. Think of like the Shining Sarcophagus archetype that Yugi got, where all the classic cards he played in his final duels, they became part of one archetype together, revolved around a single card. We could do that with Kyber. He has a lot of cards with Kaiser in their name, for example. So you can make like a collaborating Kaiser archetype. That doesn't make any sense, but still. Kaiser Glider, Kaiser Seahorse, Rude Kaiser. We've got Kaiser Vorse Soldier now. But in terms of cards Kyber used that we guess I would like to see more of, Legend, Mystical Genie of the Lamp and Ancient Lamp, Rude Kaiser, Sword Stalker, Blade Knight, Battle Ox, Judgeman, Ring of Defense and Destruction, Card of Demise, Cost Down, Saggy the Dark Clown, Spear Dragon, Attack Guidance Armor, Ryukishin Powered. Vorse Raider kind of has a new modern version in Kaiser Vorse Raider, but it's not really part of any specific archetype, to be honest with you. Fun fact, Interdimensional Matter Transporter, a trap I heavily associate with Kyber. This does have a modern retrain in the form of the continuous spell Interdimensional Matter Forwarder. It is a mouthful to say, but it's pretty cool that he got some support. And so with that, that is how many decks have spawned from Kyber's anime deck. Would you like to see this for Joey Wheeler? Does he have more decks than Kyber? I wonder, we could find that out together. Want to watch this exact same video for Yugi Moto? Well, I have a video for that right here, but you might be more interested in this one, where you can watch that if you really want to. Thank you all for watching, everybody. Catch you later.